Dear students, today we start a new theory regarding the chemical bonding, which is VS-EPR theory. Okay. So the expansion of this letters VS-EPR is valence shell electron pair repulsion theory. From the word, we can easily understand the concept of this theory, right? Valence shell electron pair repulsion, right? So when you take a molecule, covalent molecule, around atoms there will be electron pairs. It may be present in the form of lone pair as well as bond pair. There will be electron pairs. So they are belonging to what? Valence shell, right? So usually the electrons in the valence shell will involve in chemical bonding. So in the valence shell, the electron pairs will involve in repulsion, so that there is a change in the structure of a covalent molecule. For each covalent molecule, there is a predicted structure. A structure can be predicted. The predicted structure can be changed into another one. This is due to what? Electron pairs present in valence shell, they are involving in repulsion. So the theory can be easily understood with the help of the expansion of these letters, valence shell electron pair repulsion. For a molecule, for example water, the expected geometry is tetrahedral, but expected geometry will be changed into another structure like a bent structure. This is mainly due to what? Repulsion among the electron pairs present in valence shell. So we will discuss in detail. Consider Lewis structure, right? The Lewis structure is given by the theory, Lewis theory. So for a covalent molecule, theoretically we draw a structure. So using the symbol as well as valence electrons, we draw a structure for each covalent molecule. So the theory is called the Lewis theory. So for any covalent molecule, you may draw Lewis dot structure. So for that, valence electrons are very essential. Using the valence electrons, you just draw the Lewis dot structure. Finally, what we are finding, whether all the atoms are obeying octet rule or not. So we are deriving a Lewis dot structure using the 5 steps for a covalent molecule. Now the major drawback of Lewis theory is it just gives a tentative theory which does not have any experimental explanation for the structure of a molecule, right? So theoretically, using the symbols and the valence electrons of atoms in a molecule, we draw a structure. So that is a theoretical structure which was given by Lewis theory. Practically, we don't know what is the exact structure of a molecule, right? So the exact structure of a molecule can be calculated by the combination of these two theories. So as we studied bond parameters in a covalent molecule, right? So there are many bond parameters like bond angular or bond order. So many bond parameters are available for a covalent molecule, and the covalent bond is directional in nature, right? So when we take a covalent bond, the covalent bond is always directional in nature. So in the next theory, we will study in detail valence bond theory, how the orbitals are overlapping. Okay. So ionic bond formation is just merely electrostatic force of attraction between the cation and anion. A force of attraction is present, that is ionic bond. But in case of covalent bond, the atoms are sharing the electrons to make a covalent bond in a particular direction. So the atoms are orienting in particular directions. So we have 3 dimensions. In all the 3 dimensions, atoms are orienting. So this is directional nature. Covalent bond is directional nature. So the Lewis structure alone is not enough to explain the structure. Lewis structure is mainly based on symbols as well as their valence electrons, whether they are obeying octet rule or not. But what is the exact structure of a covalent molecule? That can be predicted using some other theories, right? So with the help of Lewis theory as well as VSEPR theory, a structure of a molecule can be predicted. So why a structure is changed? This is due to what? Directional nature of covalent bond. So covalent bond is a highly directional nature. Two atoms are combining at one particular direction to make a covalent bond. So due to mutual sharing of electrons, two atoms are making a covalent bond. So this overlapping, this making covalent bond is directional nature. So what are the salient features of VSEPR theory? Right? So there are 3 points. First point, electron pairs present around central atom in a molecule. So when you take any covalent molecule, around the atoms there will be what? Electron pairs, right? So atoms are mutually sharing the electrons. It makes a covalent bond. So valence electrons are responsible for the formation of a covalent bond. So when we take any covalent molecule, around the atoms there will be electron pairs. So in the Lewis dot structure, finally we check what? Whether all the atoms are obeying octet rule or not. So that we check 8 electrons present around each atom or not. So when we take any covalent molecule, there will be electron pairs around each atom. They have to obey octet rule, then only the molecule will be stabilized. So first point of VSEPR theory is electron pairs will be present around each atom. So these electron pairs are belonging to what cell? Outermost cell. We call them as valence cell. So these are valence cell electron pairs present around each atom in a covalently bonded molecule. Next, number two, the electron pairs around an atom are of two type. One is bond pair, another one is lone pair. Okay. So bond pair electron, lone pair electron. So the electron pairs are of two type in a covalent molecule. One will be present as a bonded pair, another will be present as lone pair of electrons. So this is point number two in VSEPR theory. So consider the water molecule. So H2O, water molecule. Oxygen atom shares two electrons with two oxygen atoms, isn't it? Total valence electrons of oxygen is 6. Out of 6 electrons, 2 electrons are shared with hydrogen atoms, and each hydrogen is sharing valence electron. So there is a formation of covalent bond between oxygen as well as hydrogen. So for each covalent bond, 2 electrons. We call this as bonded pair of electron or shared pair of electron. So you just observe the oxygen atom in a water molecule. Out of 6 electrons, 2 electrons are shared with hydrogen atoms to make covalent bonds. Now the 6 electrons are not present in a single type. Out of 6 electrons, these 2 electrons present in the form of what? Bond pair, isn't it? These electrons are present in the form of lone pair. So these 4 electrons of oxygen present as lone pair of electron, that means a 2 lone pair, and these electrons are present in the form of bonded pair. Okay, so according to second point of VSEPR theory, around each atom in a covalently bonded molecule there will be electron pairs either in the form of bonded pair or lone pair of electron, right? So when we take hydrogen, around the hydrogen there are 2 electrons. The 2 electrons present in the form of bonded pair. Around this hydrogen, 2 electrons present in the form of bonded pair. What about oxygen? In a molecule totally, around oxygen, 8 electrons present. It obeys octet rule. Around 8 electrons, 4 electrons present in the form of lone pair of electron, remaining four will be present in the form of bonded pair of electron. So what is the first point in VSEPR theory? Valence shell electron pairs will be present for each atom in a covalently bonded molecule. Next one, the electron pairs around an atom in a molecule may be in the form of bonded pair or lone pair of electron. Third point, there will be repulsion among the electrons in a molecule, right? Because all the electrons are having same negative charge. So same charges will always repel each other. So between the electron pairs, there will be repulsion. So the third point discuss about repulsion among the electrons. So consider lone pair repulsion. So in water molecule, around oxygen, two lone pair of electrons present. Okay. So between these lone pair of electrons, there will be repulsion. Okay. Then one more type of repulsion is there, that is lone pair bond pair repulsion. This and this interaction, lone pair and this bond pair interaction. This lone pair, this bond pair interaction, this lone pair, this bond pair interaction. So next interaction or repulsion is lone pair bond pair interaction. LP represents lone pair, BP represents bond pair electron. So when you take the simple water molecule, we have both bond pair of electron as well as lone pair of electron. Between the lone pair of electrons, there will be repulsion. At the same time, the lone pair of electrons will repel bond pair of electron. Isn't it? So for each covalent bond, two electrons or a pair of electron, we call this as shared pair or bonded pair of electron. Between the lone pairs as well as lone pair and the bond pair, repulsions will be there. One more repulsion, bond pair repulsion. So between these two, there will be repulsion between the bonded pair of electrons. So three type of repulsions are common in a covalently bonded molecule: lone pair repulsion, lone pair repulsion, and bond pair repulsion. The reason is all the electrons are having same negative charges, so that they are involving in the repulsions. Now the question is, which repulsion will be predominant? Which repulsion will be a more one? So this repulsion will be more. Always lone pair repulsion will be more. So when you compare lone pair bond pair repulsion, lone pair repulsion will be more. Then this lone pair bond pair repulsion is more than the bond pair repulsion. Okay. So this is bonded pair of electron. This is lone pair of electron. Comparing bond pair repulsion, the lone pair bond pair repulsion will be more. So this is an important one more question. So just mention the order of repulsions of electron pairs. Electron pairs will involve in a repulsion. So this is the order. Okay. Comparing bond pair, lone pair repulsion will be more. Comparing this, lone pair repulsion will be more. So this is the order. Next, why this repulsion will be more? That is the question. Because when you take any covalently bonded molecule, what about the interaction between the nucleus and the lone pair of electron? We take oxygen atom. Around oxygen, there are four electrons present in the form of lone pair. Now, these four electrons are not involving any bonding. They are present as such on oxygen atom. Now, in the oxygen atom, there are eight protons within the nucleus, right? So, eight protons present within the nucleus of oxygen is attracting these two lone pair of electrons. That means these four electrons are attracted by the nucleus of oxygen atom. So, positively charged protons present within the nucleus of oxygen. See, all the eight protons present within the nucleus of oxygen is attracting all the four lone pair of electrons. This is one case. Next one, you take the electron shared by oxygen. So this is the electron shared by oxygen with hydrogen. This is the electron shared by oxygen with hydrogen. So this is the electron shared by hydrogen with oxygen. This is the electron shared by hydrogen with oxygen. When you take this electron, this electron, which is present as a bonded pair of electron, this electron of oxygen is not only attracted by the nucleus of oxygen, this electron is also attracted by the nucleus of hydrogen, because this is present in the form of bonded pair. Due to mutual sharing of electrons, covalent bond is formed. So this electron is attracted by both the nucleus of hydrogen, nucleus of oxygen, both are attracting this electron. So comparing this electron, attraction will be more here, right? Attraction of proton by these electrons will be more. Then it occupies more space also. These lone pair of electrons are occupying more space, and which is attracted by or interacted by the nucleus of only one atom. So this will have more repulsion. So this is the reason. One more question. Okay. Why lone pair repulsion is much? The reason is what? These lone pair of electrons are occupying more space and which are attracted by the nucleus of the same atom only. So repulsion will be more. But in this case, this electron is not only attracted by the nucleus of oxygen, is also attracted by the nucleus of hydrogen. So bonded pair of electron will have less repulsion. So there are three major features of valence electron pair repulsion theory. First point, electron pairs of valence cell is involving in chemical bonding. So when you take any covalently bonded molecule, around the atoms there will be electron pairs. Electron pairs of valence cell will be present around the atoms in a covalently bonded molecule. Second point, the electron pairs may be present in the form of lone pair or in the form of bond pair. So when we take the valence cell electron pairs, they may be present in the form of lone pair as well as bonded pair. This is the second point. Third point, since all the electrons are having same charge, they will involve in repulsion. So this is the order of repulsion. Between the bond pair lone pair repulsion will be more. Comparing this lone pair bond pair, this lone pair repulsion will be more. The reason for more repulsion among the lone pair electrons is they are occupying the more space, as well as these lone pair of electrons are attracted by the nucleus of the single atom. So this is the important points in VSEPR theory. Next, many examples we are going to see. Okay, so as we discussed, when atoms are combining to produce a covalent bond, the atoms have to join in a particular direction. So there is a directional nature. Okay, when you take methane molecule, hydrogen atoms are going to make a covalent bond with the carbon. So four hydrogen atoms are going to make four covalent bonds with carbon. The process is called overlapping. Orbital of hydrogen and orbital of carbon will overlap. Overlapping means joining. By sharing the electrons, they are joining. So orbitals are overlapping by sharing of electrons. So covalent bond will be formed. Between the carbon and the hydrogen, covalent bond will be formed. So this is highly directional in nature. All the orbitals of hydrogen will orient in a particular direction, then only there will be overlapping process. So overlapping of orbitals of carbon and hydrogen will take place in a particular direction, so that this gets a three-dimensional structure. When you take any covalently bonded molecule, this will get a three-dimensional structure. So the atoms will orient in three dimensions, x, y as well as z direction, because overlapping is taking place in a particular direction. So three-dimensional structure is available for each molecule. If it is a three-dimensional structure, means between the covalent bonds there will be an angle that we studied already, bond angle. Okay. So angle between the two covalent bonds in a molecule. So this is a three-dimensional molecule. The angle between the two covalent bonds is called a bond angle. So for methane molecule, bond angle will be 109 degree 28 minute or 109.5 degree. So there will be a particular bond angle. So based on that, each molecule will get a fixed geometry. So due to this proper orientation in three dimensions, each molecule will get a particular geometry. So this is called a tetrahedron. Okay. So now think about Lewis structure as well as actual structure. So don't confuse these two structures. What is Lewis structure? Lewis structure means using this symbol as well as valence electron, we draw a structure, isn't it? So what is a Lewis structure? Carbon as well as hydrogen atoms are there. So according to Lewis structure, first we write the central atom with more electronegativity. Remaining atoms will be present in different sides, right? So front, back as well as left and right. So in four dimensions we mention it. So this is a two dimensional structure, right? So Lewis structure is a two dimensional skeletal structure framed by like this. So central atom will have more electronegativity. So in Lewis structure, first step we draw skeletal structure in a two dimensional form. So four hydrogen atoms are placed in four dimensions. Then after drawing that, we calculate what is the valence electron. So each hydrogen one, carbon four, totally 8 electrons. First step, drawing the skeletal structure. Second step, calculate valence electron for the molecule. For each hydrogen, valence electron one. So totally 4 hydrogen atoms, valence electron 4. Then for carbon, valence electron 4, totally 8. Then what is the third step? The 8 electrons will be placed as covalent bond. For each covalent bond, 2 electrons. Now all the 8 electrons are satisfied by making 4 covalent bonds. So with this Lewis structure over, isn't it? Lewis structure over. Simply we draw a two dimensional structure, that is Lewis structure. First we draw a skeletal structure based on the electronegativity of atom. Then we calculate valence electron. We place covalent bond. Extra electrons present means will be placed as lone pair of electron on more electronegative atoms. Then if they are not obeying the octet rule, then we shift the pair of electron into double bond or a triple bond. So like that we draw a Lewis structure. But what is the actual structure of this methane? This is not the structure of methane. The actual structure of methane is this one. This is called the tetrahedral structure. So this is arrived based on some other theories like valence bond theory. Okay, next we will discuss, tomorrow we will discuss about that. So this is mainly based on orientation of atoms in space. So two atomic orbitals are hybridized orbitals. The orbitals are combining at a particular direction so that we get a three-dimensional structure for a molecule. Okay, so today we see only two structures. So this is Lewis structure, a theoretical structure. This is an exact structure, right? Using the instruments, if you observe, you will get a three-dimensional structure. Okay, so in all four, in all different dimensions, the hydrogen atoms are oriented. Okay, so there is a tetrahedral structure with a bond angle 109 degree 28 minute. Okay, so for each molecule there is a structure. This expected structure may be changed due to this one. So VS EPR theory deals with what? There is a structure for a molecule, but due to the presence of electron pair repulsion, the exact structure will be formed as a disordered structure. Right. The structure is called a disordered structure. Okay, that we will discuss one by one. So for each molecule, there is an expected structure based on number of atoms or number of electrons. Around atom, how much valence electrons present? Based on valence electron, there is a predicted or expected structure. The expected structure may be changed into another form. This is mainly due to electron pair repulsion. So this valence electron pair will involve in a repulsion. Due to that repulsion, the expected structure will be deserted. So we will get a new geometry or a structure, right? So in this we will discuss about it. So with the help of Lewis as well as VSEPR theory, we may predict the structure of a molecule, covalent molecule. You just remember some basic structures. Okay. based on valence shell electron pairs around an atom, how much electron pairs present. Based on that, you just remind some structures. Two electron pairs present means geometry or structure is linear. So this will continue up to 12th standard. You just remind it. Two pair of electrons present around an atom in a covalent molecule. So the expected geometry will be linear. So three, trigonal planar. Four, tetrahedral. Just now we completed methane. So tetrahedral. Number five, pentagonal bipyramidal. Trigonal bipyramidal. Okay. Number five. Take a trigonal bipyramidal. Then six, octahedral. Then seven pair of electron. It's called a pentagonal bipyramidal. So these structures are very important. So these are expected structure when you see a molecule, right? Based on electron pairs around it, we can easily expect this will be the structure. Okay, so around an atom in a molecule, how much electron pairs present, based on that structure can be predicted. For two pair of electron linear, for three electron pairs trigonal planar, four tetrahedral, five trigonal bipyramidal, six octahedral, seven pentagonal bipyramidal. So mostly these electron pairs are applicable for central atom. Okay. Around central atom, how much electron pairs present? Based on that, we can predict the geometry. So we go one by one. First, number of electron pairs around the central atom, two. If two electron pairs present around central atom in a molecule, so the covalent molecule is generally assumed as ABX. So this is general formula for a covalent molecule, ABX. A is the central atom, B is the atom which is combined with the central atom, X represents number of atoms, B. Okay, so this is general formula for a covalent molecule. Central atom and the atom combines with the central atom, X represents how much B atoms present in the molecule. So according to VSEPR first theory, there will be valence shell electron pairs around central atom in a molecule. Okay, two electron pairs present around a central atom in a molecule. Now according to VSEPR second theory, second postulator, the electron pair may be present in the form of bonded pair as well as lone pair, right? So electron pairs of valence shell can be present in the form of bonded pair as well as lone pair. So for the central atom, the two pair of electron can be in the form of bonded pair as well as lone pair. Now we assume that the two pair of electrons present as bonded pair, so no lone pair of electrons. So what will be the formula? Formula of the covalent molecule, AB2. Central atom, around the central atom there are two valence electron pairs. Both the electron pairs present in the form of bonded pair, no lone pair of electrons. So the formula will be AB2, central atom and two combining atoms. So what will be the structure? This will be the structure. So the central atom is A. Around the central atom, there are two electron pairs. Both the electron pairs are present as bond pair of electron, no lone pair of electrons. So the formula for the molecule is AB2. What is the bond angle between this? 180 degree. Okay, bond angle 180 degree. So as we studied, for two electron pairs around the central atom, what will be the expected geometry? Expected geometry is linear. So using VSEPR theory as well as Lewis theory, we predicted a structure of a molecule. If a molecule is of AB2 type, right? For example, we take beryllium chloride. You simply compare the formula beryllium chloride with AB2. So formula is similar. Beryllium will be the central atom, then combining atom B is nothing but chlorine. So when we compare this, central atom is beryllium, combining atom is chlorine. So what will be the structure of beryllium chloride? Linear. So this structure of a covalent molecule can be predicted using the VSEPR theory as well as Lewis theory. So first we find how much valence electron pairs present around the central atom in a molecule. If two electron pairs present, we have to observe whether they are present in the form of bond pair or lone pair, or both the case, they are present in the form of bonded pair, no lone pair of electron. So this will be the formula for the molecule. A will be the central atom, two electron pairs present in the form of bonded pair. So AB2 can be represented as linear structure. Example, beryllium chloride. Beryllium will be the central atom. Both the chlorine atoms are bonded with beryllium by a covalent bond. So this is a linear structure. Between the covalent bonds, angle is 180 degree. So this is bond angle. Next, electron pairs 3. If 3 electron pairs present, what happens? So when you take 3 electron pairs, there are different possibilities. Okay, so what is the first possibility? The 3 electron pairs can be present in the form of bonded pair, 0 lone pair of electron. Okay, so for that I take the formula as AB3. Okay, A will be the central atom, B will be the combining atoms. So as we discussed already, what will be the expected geometry? For 3 electron pairs, the expected geometry will be what? Trigonal planar. Okay, this is trigonal planar. So all the 4 atoms will be in a plane. So this is a trigonal planar. Okay. So we may take an example for this. Boron trifluoride. Boron trifluoride can be taken as an example. Boron will be the central atom. Fluorine will be the combining atom. So all the 3 fluorine atoms are making a covalent bond with boron. So they are forming trigonal planar. Okay. So bond angle will be 120 degree. Between the covalent bonds, bond angle will be 120 degree. So this is first possibility. So around the central atom, if you have 3 pair of electrons present as bonded pair, the general formula will be AB3. Example is boron trifluoride. Geometry will be trigonal planar. One more possibility is there. Out of 3 electron pairs, 2 may be present as bonded pair, one may be present as a lone pair of electron. So this is another possibility. So we may write formula as Ab2L. Two combining atoms, one pair of electron as a lone pair. Capital L represents what? Lone pair of electron. So out of three combining atoms, we have only two combining atoms remaining. The central atom has a lone pair of electron. Okay, so this is formula. So take central atom A, combining atoms are B, they are making a covalent bond with the central atom. Remaining central atom has a lone pair of electron. So totally three pair of electron, two pair of electron present in the form of bonded pair, then one is present in the form of lone pair. So this is next case. So this structure is called bent structure or V-shaped. So this is bent or V-shaped structure.